The next question that comes up a lot is, all right, doc, we got a diagnosis of moyamoya. What are we going to do about it? Well, the short answer is that in almost all cases, if we really believe that it's there based on the testing, the appropriate treatment is surgery. There are certain steps we can take to reduce the risk of stroke. So we often start children on aspirin. The idea being if you thin the blood a little bit, it will move through the blood vessels better. And there are other medicines sometimes we prescribe that are alternatives or what we call adjuncts, additional medicines to aspirin. We do try to make sure we keep the blood pressure up. And that means that we try to keep the kids from avoiding dehydration. So if they have a fever, if they're out running around on a hot day, we make sure they drink a lot of water so their blood pressure doesn't drop. Because if the blood pressure drops, the blood supply of the brain isn't as good, and that can lead to a stroke. So aspirin, fluids, and in some cases, we try to avoid hyperventilating. Because when people breathe really fast, if they're screaming or yelling, it can cause a reflex in blood vessels in the brain to narrow down, and that can lead to a stroke. So our hope is that by avoiding those things, avoiding dehydration, avoiding screaming or hyperventilating and adding some aspirin, we reduce the risk of stroke. But ultimately, the treatment will involve surgery, and this is something that's recommended by the American Heart Association guidelines. This is something that many hospitals do. I think here at Boston Children's, on some of the national databases, we have the largest volume of treating this in kids in the country. And while it's a rare condition, it's something we see a lot of, and the sort of data really strongly supports that surgery is the best way to try to address this.